I can tell you right now without a doubt that if I have my period, there is no way that I'm putting on like a pair of jeans. Within 10, 15 minutes, I'm actually experiencing more cramping. Can't believe I'm gonna talk about like my undergarments in this video, but I will. So today, just a quick video about endometriosis in clothing, which might seem like what, but if you have endometriosis, you might have noticed that clothing can really impact your pain, your level of pain. And especially when I have my period, which is when I experience the most pain in the month, those are times when like I really gotta like, you know, figure out what I'm gonna wear, especially if it's a day where my pain is not bad enough that I am able to go to work. I can't, you know, show up at work in like complete sweatpants. So I've found a few things over the years, just like real basic things that actually my friends and I kind of joke about, like my foam bra, which you will see in this video. But these things can really help alleviate, I mean, you know, not treat the pain, but they can really help you manage pain and at least not add to pain. Because I can tell you right now without a doubt that if I have my period, there is no way that I'm putting on like a pair of jeans. Like I'm also just, jeans are just never usually comfortable to me, but like, but definitely when I have my period, like having like a, you know, a really like jean material that's like really constricting on my pelvic area, like that's not gonna help me with my pain when I'm at work. And I also have definitely experienced times when I've had really bad pain and I've tried to wear clothing that isn't probably like as loose or as soft as other kinds of clothing. And I definitely noticed that I put that on within 10, 15 minutes, I'm actually experiencing more cramping. So the first thing is, let's start with the foam bra, okay? So years ago, I was at Walmart, and hey, if you're not like a Walmart person, that's okay. You could probably get this kind of foam bra anywhere, like on Amazon. And so I definitely find like, I can't believe I'm gonna talk about like my undergarments in this video, but I will, because I know that it's a real thing. And so the first thing is that when I have my period, I don't wanna be adding any kind of constriction or pressure on anywhere in like my torso area. So that includes like my chest area, that includes like my stomach, and it includes my pelvic area. So I wanna like free up as much tension as I can when I have my period. And again, this is kind of in the context of if you have to go out in the world, you have to go to a job or school or, you know, an exam, I've worn sweats to school and exams all the time. But if you need to be at work or in a situation where you can't wear sweats, here are a few tips. So my foam bra, foam is an F-O-A-M, my foam bra, which I got at Walmart years ago. It looks like this. It's kind of in rough shape, but it still works. I have like three of them. And so it is literally just a bra that looks like this. It's like, and I always up a size. So I go for like one size bigger than like I normally would be, because it's just like, this kind of stretch is like not super like tight and hard. It's like pretty loose. It has like foam cups inside of it, so it like gives me like, I don't know, a little bit of something. And then the straps are just like really thin and soft. And so that, this is such a comfortable bra. Again, I have it, I've bought this before at Walmart, but you can probably find one on Amazon or I don't know, any kind of store would have something kind of like that. When I put that on, it just takes away any pressure that's around my chest area, and it kind of frees things up a little bit. So that's one. The next thing is underwear. So here's the deal with underwear is like, when I have my period, again, like in that lower pelvic area, I do not want to have any kind of like tight, like, you know, there's underwear that has like those like really tight bands around them, and like, that just digs right into my ovaries probably, or like my uterus, and can really increase pain. So these are underwear that I'm about to show you. I live in Canada, and so there's a grocery store here called Superstore, and they have a line of clothing by a brand called Joe Fresh. And so these underwear, here they are, have like a really soft, it's lace, but I find that lace is just like really stretchy. It's not a rough lace. And this is what goes on like right on my pelvic area. And there's no, it's just like super stretchy and like soft, and it's not digging into me. And I really find that having underwear like that, and they're cotton as well, so they're not like that kind of like, you know, any kind of like spandex, silky, like you just want cotton, as I do, you just want like cotton underwear, and like, just want to like, you just want to have like, you know, no constriction around your pelvic area. So again, those are from Joe Fresh, but I have seen underwear like that, like pretty much anywhere. So try to find some good underwear that really ease up that area. The last thing is, okay, so this has been like, it's hard to find pants, leggings that that don't have like heavy stitching around the pelvic area that are really soft. Again, these are actually also from Joe Fresh, but I have another pair from I'm wearing a pair from Old Navy that are also like really soft on like the waist area. And so again, like these leggings are really soft around the waistband. They're super stretchy. And what you want to look for is like the seams on these. You can just test this out like in a store. When you look at the seam, like around like the bottom of the waistband and the top, you just want to make sure that there's like nice stretch in there. Because there are leggings that you can get that are like really like suck you in and like, you know, tummy shape, like whatever, tummy shaping, like all this stuff, right? And those just like, you know, they put so much constriction and pressure on that area, and it can like really cause a lot of like cramping. So try to find sweats that have like, again, the ones I'm wearing right now, they're just like also gray, and they're actually fleece inside. They're from Old Navy, they're really soft in my waistband. And just look at them in the store and just sort of make sure that you've got some good stretch. So yeah, so having some really comfortable leggings that are in like a nice neutral color, like black or gray. You know, I wear that stuff to work actually like a lot, but definitely when you have your period, you know, wearing leggings like that and then wearing like, you know, an oversized, you know, nice sweater that kind of like, you know, kind of looks stylish, I guess, where you can wear it over top, or like even some sort of like loose fitting, comfortable dress over top. You know, I wear like nice shoes and like throw a scarf around and like I look totally put together, but secretly I'm just wearing these like really comfortable leggings that really just ease up the pressure on my pelvic area and make me feel a lot more comfortable. So I hope those three ideas kind of help guide you in terms of like endometriosis in clothing is a real thing. It's something that I try to manage every month, is like making sure that all of these clothes are like clean and like ready to go. Because you know, I do go to work and I work part-time, and some days I do miss work because of my endo, but other days I'm there and I'm just trying to like survive those days, and having some comfortable clothing can really help me get through those times. So I hope this was helpful for you. Make sure you like and subscribe to my channel, because I have lots more endo videos coming for you. Bye-bye.